When looking at how we use energy in the United States, it may not surprise you that most of it is used for us getting around. Think of fueling and powering our cars, planes, ships, and big trucks. Transportation of people and all our stuff accounts for 31% of all carbon emissions in the US.
So that means if you want to reduce your carbon footprint, one of the biggest ways you can make a difference is how you get around.
School is all the way across town, and I'm not walking or riding my bike. It's just too far.
That's fair, but depending on where you live, you could take the bus or catch the train. Some transportation agencies use electric bus lines or hybrid buses, which reduce the use of fossil fuels. Riding together always uses less energy, no matter the technology. Even carpooling works.
But I want to arrive in style. If I drive an electric car, is that enough?
It depends on where you live. If your electricity comes from coal power plants, you're not really helping the environment at all. But in other places, where the electricity comes from cleaner sources, it could be a good thing.
Electric vehicles have no tailpipe emissions, so when you burn gasoline, you're creating greenhouse gases like carbon or other air pollution. But electric vehicles, the only emissions associated with them come from the electrical grid. PG&E's electrical generation is about 50% greenhouse gas free. So people who drive EVs have about a 60% reduction in their carbon footprint. The fuel is electricity. It's stored in a battery, and then that powers an electric motor to move the car. There are two main drawbacks to electric vehicles. One is the price. They're a little bit more expensive than a conventional vehicle, but the prices are coming down, and that's really driven by the price of batteries. The other main drawback is the range of electric vehicles. Today, they can only go about 80 to 100 miles on a charge. We're seeing newer models come out that will have 200 or 300 mile ranges.
Great, then I'm getting myself an electric car.
I don't mind taking the bus to school, but I do want to travel and see the world. However, I understand that traveling by airplane uses a lot of fuel. How can we reduce our use of fossil fuels for flights?
I've heard a lot about biofuels for airlines and even for big trucks that carry supplies over long distances. Is this a greener option?
Anything that's an organic material can become a biofuel. Anything from algae you grow in the tank or harvest from the ocean to crops that we grow for food. The challenge is that essentially any time that you devote large agricultural or rural areas into biofuel, you are competing with nature. You are competing with food. One of the sort of toughest nuts to crack in the green energy game is the high density, high energy fuel you need to run airplanes. This is one of the places where using biofuels that are certified as sustainable looks like an attractive place to go. Trucks turn out to be a natural place to think about big batteries or hydrogen fuel cell vehicles.
So it seems there can be other options. Where do you stand? Do you think we can get more Americans to use public transportation? Are biofuels enough? Or should we focus on making a grid for electric cars? Think about it.